Gospel of February 7, 2016, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled for their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that they were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him, and all those with him. And likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us take a pick of the first reading from the prophet Isaiah. In the year of King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord seated on a high and lofty throne. Seraphim were crying one to the other, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. All the earth is filled with his glory." I said, "Woe is me, I am doomed, for I am a man of unclean lips, and have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." One of the seraphims flew, holding an ember taken from the altar. He touched my mouth with it. "See, now this has touched your lips. Your wickedness is removed, your sin purged." Then I heard the Lord say, "Who shall I send? Here I am," I said, "send me." And also from the Corinthians, he says, "By the grace of God I am what I am, and his grace to me has not been ineffective. I have toiled harder than all, not I, but the grace of God that is with me." All right. In the Gospel, we see the calling of the Lord. Jesus is at the shore of this lake, Gennesaret. It's called by the evangelist, but it's the same lake as Galilee or all of that. And he needs to teach the crowd, but he doesn't want to be pressed or trampled, even worse. So he steps into a boat, the one belonging to Simon. The fishermen there, two boats, who had departed the night before to try to catch something and toiled heavily all through the night without catching anything. They must have been frustrated, tired, and sad, perhaps because out of all their work they couldn't catch anything. Yet Simon is good enough to allow the Lord into his boat so that he can comfortably teach the crowd. But after perhaps 2 or 3 hours or even 4 hours of teaching, the Lord tells the fishermen, "Let's go deep so that you can lower your net for a catch." Immediately he is answered, "Master, we have been toiling all night long when we are supposed to, and we couldn't get anything. But on your command, I will do it." And then, interestingly enough, Simon takes the risk. Perhaps He was ready to rebuke the Lord if no catch was made. But amazement, a great amazement, is at hand because he catches such a great catch as never before he had ever been able. With one boat, he catches so much fish that the two boats he had on hand were almost sinking. And then he realizes that that is done because the man that is in front of him is holy. So he falls to his knees and says those words. Get away from me, because I am a sinner. And like that ember that has touched the lips of Isaiah, also touches the heart of all those men by the words of the Lord. Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching men. That is an incredible proposition. For when we catch fish, we can sell the fish or we can eat the fish. But where is the profit of catching men? Well, it's not a worldly profit. It's a heavenly profit, certainly. We see how Isaiah recounts the time when he was called into the service of the Lord by that ember, who basically is the finger of God, who touched him, who purged his sins. And also, we hear that grace, again, the Holy Spirit working in the person of Paul, the apostle. Today, the Lord speaking to us about vocation, about calling. There might be someone among you, you who listen to me today, that feels something inside by this calling. Do not be afraid. Leave everything and search for God if you feel that. For everyone else, the Lord insists that by our baptism we are called to become fishermen of men, that we are to caught our brothers for him, and our profit will be life eternal. Do not be afraid. Rather than using your nets, the nets that we will use are good works and the grace that God has given us. For seeing our good works, they will glorify God, our Father, who is in heaven. Let us pray for each other, but especially let us pray for priesthood and religious vocations, that the good Lord, our Father, may send his laborers to his field. Until we meet in heaven, God bless you all, brothers.